English Shorthand Junior Grade, May 1972. Dear Governor, colleagues and friends, on behalf of the state of Tamil Nadu, I extend a hearty welcome to the delegates and visitors who have come to attend this seminar from various countries and from other distant states of India. I thank the organizers who have taken all the pains to conduct this seminar. It is most appropriate that this seminar is held in Tamil Nadu, the state which has come out with flying colors in tiding over the crisis of acute food shortage and severe drought conditions, and paved the way for the successful implementation of the Green Revolution in this part of our country. This was possible mainly due to the active cooperation extended by the people and by the officials to the government in this direction. The basic wants of any man to which our country he belongs are food, clothing, and a house to live in. Food is more essential for man's living, so also clothing, to protect the modesty of man, and he requires a house to live in. Man is worried about his food more, as without it he cannot survive at all. Then only he can think about clothing and shelter. Rice occupies a more important place among other food grains. The rice available should be fit for eating and also nutritious, and it should also be available at a reasonable rate. All governments are concentrating on the processing and devising of various measures to achieve this end, and also taking efforts to train the agriculturists in augmenting food production. When there was a serious shortage of rice, and when the price of rice was soaring up beyond the reach of the poor people, our late Honorable Chief Minister Anna introduced the Rupee a Measure scheme. This had an immediate and remarkable effect. The rise in the price of rice and other food grains was controlled. At the same time, concrete measures were undertaken to increase food production. The state of Tamil Nadu has today passed from a stage of dependence to a situation of surplus. At present, we are facing many new problems. When there was shortage, paddy was directly lifted to rice mills from the fields. But when rice is available in plenty, the question of storage of the stock arises. As such, we have to stock the paddy safely and care has to be taken to preserve them in good condition. Dear sir, in reply to our letter of the 15th instant pertaining to the export of our film to New York, we hasten to write to you that the export is intended to be made only to the territory covered by the registration certificates and not New York as such. The additional print and trailers are to be sent to New York only for subtitling, and New York itself is not the final destination. Regarding the price, you will please note that only after several rounds of talks and repeated negotiations with the party, we have been able to obtain the present price, which we consider to be the maximum that could be obtained for the picture in question. Further, the party who has signed the contract with us is a reputed and regular buyer of Indian films and has always been reasonable in this respect. The price accepted by us is not very low. Thanking you.